discussion that the board on Grange Hall is a historical building, and as such, there are a few things to keep in mind. The exits are up the stage to the right and downstairs to the right of the bathroom. In case of a fire, proceed to the nearest exit. There are no open flames permitted. Smoking inside the building is prohibited. And please dispose of your cigarette butts in the cans placed outside. Thank you for your help in keeping this building safe for another 100 years. Welcome, family, friends, and loved ones. We gather here today surrounded by the beauty of creation and the sights of history of this building and those who have come before. To celebrate the wedding of Uncle Jim and Mark, you have come here from nearby and from far away to share in this commitment now they make to one another, to offer your love and support in the reunion, and to allow Uncle Jim and Mark to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them. Uncle Jim and Mark, thank you for your presence here today. They ask for your blessing, encouragement, and lifelong support in their decision to be married. They also remember other loved ones who cannot be here to share this moment with them today. Those people, too, they hold dear in their hearts. Uncle Jim, Mark, marriage is a promise between two people who love each other, who trust that love, who honor one another as individuals in that togetherness, and who wish to spend the rest of their lives together. It enables the two separate souls to share their desires, longings, dreams, and memories, their joys and sorrows, and to help each other through all uncertainties in life. A strong marriage also nurtures each of you as separate individuals and allows you to maintain your unique identity and grow in your own way through the years ahead. It is a safe haven for each of you to become the best of yourself. While together, you become better than ever could be alone. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of deep trust. You are agreeing to share strength, responsibilities, and love to make the relationship work. It takes trust to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow, even when
titled, From All I Ever Really Needed to Know, I Learned in Kindergarten, by Robert Fulghum. All of what I really need to know about how to live and what to do and how to be, I learned in kindergarten. Wisdom was not at the top of the graduate class mountain, but there is a sandbox at nursery school. These are the things I learned. Share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people. Put things back where you found them. Clean up your own mess. Don't take things that aren't yours. Say sorry when you hurt somebody. Wash your hands before you eat. Always flush. Warm cookies and cold milk are good for you. Give them to someone who feels sad. Live a balanced life. Learn some, think some, draw, paint, sing, dance, play, and work every day. Take a nap every afternoon. Be aware of wonder. Remember the little seed in the plastic cup. The roots go down, the plant goes up, and nobody ever knows really how or why, but we are all like that. Everything you need to know is in there somewhere. And it is still true, no matter how old you are, when you go out into the world, it is best to hold hands and to stick together.
Thank you, Becca.
You're welcome.
When you go into the world, it is best to hold hands and stick together. That's the best advice in that reading. It is truly better to stick together and walk this journey with each other. I know Jim and Mark are so blessed to have the family and friends they have who walk this journey with them. We aren't meant to do life alone. All of you here are part of their journey, so you should get to know each other. Let's take a minute to greet those around you. Say hello to your neighbor.
Wonderwall. Mark, You know, it's funny, I had something written out, but I know it's a movie cliche, so I'm sorry for saying that, but I had something written out, but I met Mark a very long time ago. I was in a horrible place, and he was my dad's boyfriend, and I came over to his house, and more than the love that I felt for my father, I felt for a man I'd never met. This man loved my siblings and loved us. Loved my father when he was a broken man, loved all of us when we were broken people, and he helped us become the people we are now, helped us become whole again, and I can't ever thank you enough for that. I can't ever imagine a man that would be better for my father.
By your side, who truly cares enough when the world hurts you and it makes you feel vulnerable. Marriage offers the promise that there will be someone willing to listen, to console you, and to inspire you. Marriage is a joining of two who share the promise that only a marriage can make, to share the sunshine and the shadows, and to experience a richer, more fulfilling life because of it. You guys truly, it's you, me, us, and we. You got a great family.
Thank you, Auntie, for that reading. Melissa, you can come. Marriage. Marriage is about giving and taking, forging and forsaking, kissing and loving and pushing and shoving, caring and sharing, screaming and swearing, and about being together whatever the weather, about being driven to the end of your tether, about sweetness and kindness and wisdom and blindness. It's about being strong when you're feeling quite weak. It's about saying nothing when you're dying to speak. It's about being wrong when you are right. It's about giving in before there's a fight. It's about you two living as cheaply as one, and you can all give us a call if you can figure out how that's done. Never heeding advice that was always well meant, never counting the cost until it's all spent. And for you two today, it's about to begin, and for all that the two of you had to put in. Some days filled with joy and some days filled with sadness. Too late, you'll discover that Mira doesn't have this. Serenity, peace, honesty, expression, loyalty, and patience. Orange represents kindness, attraction, support, communication, and sensitivity. It is gold. Can't see that, we're gonna pretend. Gold represents intelligence, unity, energy, and religious blessings. Red represents passion, strength, bravery, and lasting love.
Don't you remember back in reading? You are not the air that I breathe. You are the sweet scent that drifts upon it. You are not the sounds that I hear. You are the music to my life. You are not the food that I need. You are the nourishment of my soul. You are not my will to survive. You are my reason for living. It is with you that I experience the wonders of the world. It is you that calms my restless nature. It is through you that I know my true self. I do not take you for granted. I cherish you. I do not need you. I choose you. I choose you today in witness of all the people who love us. I choose you tomorrow in the privacy of our hearts. I choose you in strength and weakness. I choose you in health and sickness. I choose you in joy and sorrow. And I will choose you over all others, every day and for the rest of my life.
You are not the air I breathe. You are the sweet scent that drifts upon. You are not the sounds I hear. You are the music to my life. You are not the food that I need. You are the nourishment of my soul. You are not my will to survive. You are my reason for living. It is with you that I experience the wonders of the world. It is you that calms my restless nature. It is through you that I know my true self. I do not take you for granted. I cherish you. I do not need you. I choose you. I choose you today in witness of all the people who love us, the privacy of our hearts. I choose you in strength and weakness. I choose you in health and sickness. I choose you in joy and sorrow. I will choose you over all others every day and for the rest of my life.
Okay, this video just earned a TV PG rating.
Thank you.
Didn't expect to have a camera shoved in your face,
no,
huh?
No, I didn't.
You can thank Dan for this one.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he bought me this a couple years ago for Christmas.
Oh, no kidding.
It was a Christmas present.
Nice.
I gotta say, where did you find them?
Syracuse University. It's their a cappella group. They did it because it helps them raise funds for their group. They knocked it out of the park. They sent me a recording 2 days ago, and I was like, that is not what I expected. So, it was
really good. Hey, dumbass.
Hi.
I used to change his diapers.
Well, oh, you
this is my uncle.
Well, I can tell you, that's me that you got.
Right?
You know what? The kids are in the water.
Nah, I got pretty great kids. I wouldn't want to deny them. I don't know where he gets them.
Really?
I'm not an asshole.
This video's pushing into TV-14 category now.
Listen, you are at this wedding, it's R-rated. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
TVMA rating, then.
Yeah.
Especially this table.
Right? I really didn't want to actually love it and get settled there. I don't want to be there long. This is like a
few minutes. Kyle, are you trying to gay it up?
Yeah.
You're right up the street, so you should come down.
We were talking about that one time. We should get together and take Cards Against Humanity.
Sure, I've never played that, but sure. She's like, you're
seriously
like 3 minutes.
Cards Against Humanity.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Just give me that ugly look back up. Come
on.
Are we doing it?
No.
Okay.
Oh hell no.
Worked it so hard my hair fell out.
Imagine worrying about the neighbor wandering over to your
front yard. Excuse me.
I've done it.
Okay. Yeah, I think the three of us should really consider the room. All right, honey, all right.
to sit down here. They're hungry. They want to eat.
So there's you and Becca. Those are the only two left to carry in.
Before you can even ask.
I already feel part of the family.
No, I hear you. Hey! Thank you so much, guys, for coming. It's been amazing. Thank you.
Thank Dan.
Absolutely.
I would just say, fuck it, I'll stay home.
Right, and drink.
No, I just stay home, drink coffee, and watch the dog.
Very true.
Okay, I'm going against the tide here.
We should, you know, have our own little group. Some of us that come voluntarily.
What would we name ourselves?
I don't know. I have to think of that.
Have to be.
What in the hell are you talking about?
Meat.
Yes, Becca is definitely a carnivore.
I'm a carnivore.
Huh?
What? Oh no, not the lines like all the way
down. Auntie's porchetta?
Yeah, porchetta.
Oh, porchetta.
Auntie Lisa's porchetta.
Auntie's porchetta.
Hold on.
Where are they?
Hey, Auntie, would you grab me one?
A what?
Yeah, we'll get you a mirror bag.
Oh, yes, I am making a nuisance of myself.
You're great. You're doing a great job.
Aside from one little mishap.
Thank you.
Aside from one little mishap.
What's the mishap?
I accidentally opened a memory card cover.
Okay.
So it got interrupted for about maybe 30 seconds.
That's all right.
Which pissed me off.
What do you need?
To try to get upstairs.
Okay. I'm going to put my butt on all
We're going against the grain. I'm sorry, you're all getting
The last thing is, guys, you got to talk it out. No matter what it is, you need to just stop, take a breath.
Okay, I noticed in your top three, though,
sex is not important. It's fun, but it's not important. I know you like fun, so have fun. But what
did you hear that? That's from my aunt.
She didn't. I'm in order.
What I'm saying is, never go to bed.
I just called Mika to check in.
We don't.
Daniel.
Do not go to bed angry.
Daniel.
If you have to stay up till 3 o'clock.
I just called Mika to check in, see how things are going. She says everything's fine.
No, we don't.
And laugh and beg. Because that's the best part. Laugh and beg.
Don't touch me like that. We think we're freaking married.
Yes.
Right now, I can touch you anytime and any place I want.
Look at me. There you go. I'm married. Okay.
By the way, Lord,
save the grab ass for when you get home.
18 years we've been together, four major arguments, and the only time.
Yeah.
Oh.
Right. I'm sorry.
Now what are you trying to knock your old uncle down?
Better than your food touching you.
There you go.
Oh my God, you're actually drinking wine, Agnes?
No.
No, she is.
Who, Barb is?
Barb, yeah, she never drinks. She's going to be beat red in about 10 minutes.
Oh, jeez.
Trying to warm up my body.
Well, yeah, it is a little chilly in here.
We could make a bonfire, maybe.
FYI, I am her brother.
Oh, Jason, nice to meet you.
Dean. Sorry, got my hand full.
I'm Barb's son.
Yes, yeah. I kind of figured that.
And this is my partner.
Your partner, yes. That bald headed little guy there is my husband.
Where is he? Oh, okay, yeah.
The one who did the food.
So I saw you taking the pictures. So are you the official photographer?
No.
He's just very good at it.
Very good at it.
What?
You're very good at it.
Yes, I am.
I'm horrible. I try to take pictures. Every time I take a picture, someone's either blocking them or their eyes are closed. I just have bad luck.
Well, that's when you hip check them and say, get the hell out of my way.
I guess you have to do like a series of pictures or something. Yeah.
Well, given that we are the smartphone generation, I mean.
You never know. You don't ever know.
I am in your face.
You are in my face.
That's right.
Oh, what, do you want me to say something?
No.
Okay.
Give him a couple of, you give him some suspenders, he could do a Larry King impression.
Sean.
Yes! No, thank you, I already got one.
Yeah.
All right, this video just definitely went TVMA.
But would you expect anything else from our family?
No. Our wedding was more tame compared to this.
Yes.
There you go.
Wait. Can I just get a strip club?
It opened.
Yeah, me.
I already got you. Because you got me close up, like, ooh.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dean.
You're welcome.
I love you, man.
Love you too, Lisa.
I love you.
I should have known. Why is that appropriate?
What? I see what you're doing.
Yes, I'm gathering evidence for blackmail. Sweetheart, everything's going on YouTube anyway.
There's so much more going on.
Yes, but few amusing people.
Get out of here!
Oh, sorry. What you looking for, dear?
Water.
Water? Okay. Water is, excuse me, we need to get at the water. The water is right here.
Okay. It's
right here. I may poke an eye out with it, but I don't know.
Is anyone speaking?
Yeah, Aiden.
Aiden is? Okay.
I love that sound.
Me too.
Okay.
Oh, I hear clinking.
Hello. We're doing a toast.
That's how babies happen.
I don't think so.
I think you're a little too old to be knocked up, Jim.
You never know.
And too male. It is too male.
We just need to hear you.
Okay. All right.
Hello. You have to speak louder than that.
Hello.
You're how?
Hey, everyone, what's up?
Yeah.
Get in here, phone. Our kid's got something to say.
I do. Now I want you to listen. No, first thing I want to say is, well, I don't have a drink, but imagine I do. Whenever our family gets together, we always have a good time. You know, everyone always has stories, something to say, and it's always fun. And now that it's official, I'm glad that Mark is able to be a part of that, and a part of the family. Now, there is some confusion, because usually in a marriage, there's one person who's always right, and then there's the husband. In this case, there's two. No, but all jokes aside, I really appreciate these two. Thank you all for making this a part of your day, and I'm really proud to have two gay dads, especially considering if only one was gay, it'd be kind of weird. Here's to many years of love and happiness. Cheers.
Cider, you can drink it.
I didn't know if it was yours.
You're not driving, you're good. Cool.
You want to say anything?
Me? It doesn't even matter. Do I want to? Do I have to stand?
You have to stand.
Jeez!
Get your butt out of the chair, Jim.
Take it off.
Okay.
Tell him, Daddy.
I wasn't expecting to speak. Hold on. Where's my presentation? No, I'm just kidding. First of all, there are a couple people that Mark and I really have to thank for pulling this wedding off, because. So who are they?
Back,
turn up your hearing aid.
I did.
All right. Wendy's old.
Change your bell tone.
It beeps too loud.
So I want to thank Mark's dad. Where are you?
I
wave to the people. I also want to thank Mark's stepmom Sue. A lot of what you see here, especially decoration-wise, she helped pull together and helped with the details that pulled all of this off. So, Sue, thank you so much. My nieces, holy crap. So, my niece Kaylee got ordained to be able to marry Mark and I. And my niece Krista did the hand fasting ceremony, so thank you guys so much. Yes, Olivia and Emma, our beautiful flower girls, our lantern bearers. Thank you. You guys were great. So, fun story about the decorations to pull all this off. Mark, in his most diplomatic form.
we'll go with that.
Yeah, got everybody together in our wedding party and pulled off the decorations and the setup. And we asked you guys, because you guys have been such a huge part of our lives for the last 4 years. My Aunt Lisa, where is she? She's probably been, Mark and I personally, our biggest champion over the last 4 years. So she's always been encouraging us, always been supporting us. My Aunt Lisa and my Uncle Dan did the food today. Thank you guys so much.
It's called Lee.
My auntie Lisa.
There we go. We're good.
Oh my gosh, there's so many. Wow, boys, I am so proud of all of you guys. Nathan, you especially, thank you so much for the last couple days. We wouldn't have been able to pull this off if it wasn't for your help.
Way to lose
the ranks,
David.
No. Well, he's the oldest, so. Who else? Let's see. Linda. Oh my gosh, Linda. Thank you so much for hanging out today, working the chair lifts.
Thank you for the facility.
Woo! Linda! MVP!
Linda!
And I guess the other person I need to thank is, I really need to thank Mark. He has stepped into my life like a flipping hurricane. And everything that I had planned went completely out the window when he said, yeah, let's go on a date. And I told him I had four kids, and he was like, okay. And I'm like, you're not going to run? but seriously, Mark, you have helped me kind of find my groove again. You have helped me reestablish a family with my kids again. And thank you is not even enough to tell you. So I would marry you 100 times over. I really would. So. Thank you all so much. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. All right, so for purposes of pictures, we're going to go cut the cake. Do you want some cake now? Have some cake now? But we're just going to cut it so people get the pictures that they need, and then it's time to party.
It sure is.
Yo!
Hey! All right, let's go.
I think I'll kill it. I'm fine.
Just cut a little, wherever you got to do it to get you guys done.
Can I stand back like 5 feet and just chuck the knife?
I mean, if you want to, today's your day.
Hey, does anybody got a sword? That'd be way cooler.
Can't
wave
sharp objects. Your mom's not here.
Ready?
Is everyone around that wants to get pictures? Can everyone see? Ready?
Do it there, pal.
Look at what you did.
Just cut enough piece. You guys are doing. Are you guys feeding each other?
No.
Yes, you are.
No, we are.
Cakes? Yes.
No.
Okay. You smash cake.
I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna. No. That's the best part.
You gotta do it.
Come on.
Don't listen to
him. We will.
That's it.
Time.
You smash
just
the cake.
Another time. Now feed each other the cakes. Put it in your cake.
You do?
Oh. I have kind of super glue, don't worry.
I'm not putting that in my cake.
Are you ready?
I'm not
gonna smash.
Don't
smash.
How are you gonna be mad about that much cake?
Nice. I'm fat. I need more cake.
Smash it.
Ready?
Come on.
I had cake smashed in my face in my wedding.
Nice.
That's not a cream of glory.
It's okay.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to take my whole hand and just grab
that
whole scoop of flour and just be like, Jimmy! Oh hey, baby!
Hey, what up, asshole?
You're good.
Hey, Jack! Hey! Oh, shit!
All right, Lori.
I want the furry.
Oh, it's so nice.
I got to take a picture with you guys before I leave, okay?
Oh! Okay, this is my jam.